Even with one of the cheapest CNC mills, like this 1610 Chinese engraving machine, we can still achieve tremendous accuracy without any expensive tools. Today, I'll show you how to calibrate the positioning of the axis to about 3/1000ths of a millimeter, or 1/10000ths of an inch. Let's go! First, we'll figure out the basic concepts. The axes are driven by a stepper motor, which, as the name implies, works based on steps. And there are a certain number of steps per revolution, usually 200. Microstepping then multiplies the number of steps per revolution and allows for greater stepping resolution. Each step then turns either a gear with a belt or rack, or, like on my machine, a lead screw which moves the carriage. We need to tell our CNC machine that a certain number of steps corresponds to a certain length of travel distance. Luckily, there's a handy tool on my website. I'll put in the number of steps per revolution. It gives me the degrees per step. I have 8 microstepping on this machine, and the lead on my screw is 2 millimeters. Lead is how far the carriage will move for one full turn of the screw. If you have a basic gear and belt or rack system, you can enter the gear reference diameter instead. And so I'll set this axis to 800 steps per millimeter. The firmware on my machine is Garble, and I'm using Candle as the interface. If you're using something else, you'll have to look up how it's configured, but the numbers will be the same. As you can see, the machine is already configured this way from the factory. Now we can do the calibration. The basic concept is to move the carriage, or the tip of a tool, a certain known distance, and compare that to how far the controller thinks it has moved. We can then calculate and adjust the machine accordingly. I'll show you two methods, but there are several. First, we'll use a ruler, since that's the easiest and requires no setup. The pointier the tool, the better. Make sure that your ruler is parallel to the axis by gently pressing the ruler against the tool as you secure it. Pick a starting point and zero the axis. Now move the tool a precise distance according to the ruler. I'm going for 140 millimeters. Now we'll check the controller. How far does it think we've gone? 139.333 millimeters. That's almost 7/10ths of a millimeter, or 26 thou of error, which is quite large, but we can fix that. Input your current setup and the known length. We don't need to account for the tool with this method. And then input how far the machine thinks it moved. We get a calibrated value of 796.189 steps per millimeter. Update the configuration of the machine and reset it so we can make the same measurement again. (140.039 millimeters). 4/100ths of a millimeter, or 1.5 thou, is much better. But it's not enough, and I think we can do even better with the second method. This method requires some setup, but all we really need is a battery, an LED, and some wires. We're going to make the CNC part of a simple circuit and use the LED to precisely indicate the positioning. We'll need two metal parts with known dimensions. I'm going to use the table of the machine and this rod because it's long and has a smooth surface. The rod is slightly undersized, so I'll use packing tape to increase the thickness. It works best if you have your name on it. But unfortunately, aluminum isn't electrically conductive. The extrusion is actually laminated, but it's only a thin layer, so we'll remove it with fine grit sandpaper. Now it works. but we'll need to know the dimensions of the table. Now, we can position the tool on one side with very high precision, zero the axis, and do the same thing on the other side. We'll enter the values in our handy tool so we don't mess up on the math. Now we can configure the axis with the calibrated value and do the same measurement again to check our error. .587 means we have an error of only 0.03 of a millimeter, or 0.1 thou, which is certainly a small error. Although it's worth mentioning that my digital caliper only measures hundreds of millimeters and that it's not a calibrated and certified instrument, which means we can't truly trust this level of accuracy. But we can trust that we've successfully calibrated the machine to as high a precision as we are capable of measuring. Well done. Hey, if you like this video, you should definitely subscribe to my channel for a new video every week. Click that button now. Thanks.